us. They manifest themselves among them. How many of you know that? So can you stand to your feet and give him the highest hallelujah? Wave those hands to Jesus.
God bless you as you come and go ahead and share. God bless you as you come and just go ahead and share and invite others. Go ahead and share and invite others. As you come in, go ahead and share. Just share, share, and invite others. God bless you as you share. As you come in, go ahead and share. God bless you as you tune in. Go ahead and share. Go ahead and share and invite others. God bless you. How is everyone doing? God bless you. God bless you as you tune in. Just go ahead and share. We're going to be really quick. I'm very strong in the Lord. I'm very, very strong. It's my strongest night ever. God bless you as you tune in. Just go ahead and share. Go ahead and share. Go ahead and share and invite others. I'm just doing some invites myself. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you. God bless you. Tonight, we are not going to be loud. We're going to be really quick. I just want to bless you from a strange land. I just want to bless your life from a strange land. I'm bringing you blessings from Houston, Texas. God bless you as you tune in. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you as you tune in. Just go ahead and share and invite others. I love you so much too. God bless you. Go ahead and share. Invite others so we can go ahead and just be quick. We can never be tired. We can never be tired. It's an heavenly rest. We can never be tired. It's an heavenly rest. Until we see Jesus, until you have your testimony, the devil cannot have peace. The devil cannot have peace until you receive. I cannot stop praying for you. Go ahead and share. Invite someone. We're going to be real quick. You don't want to miss the blessing from Houston. Trust me, you don't want to miss this blessing from a strange land. You don't want to miss this blessing from Houston. The Bible speaking says, when the children of God steps on a strange land, Rama Santaradaboskaya, strange things begins to happen. Strange anointing, strange spirits, strange success, strange relationship, strange marriage, strange promotions, strange things are coming to you. I'm gonna be real quick. Today have been all over. Anointing has been all over me. I've been prophesying. I've been praying for people. Right from when I left till I got to the airport, I was still praying for people, reading my Bible, seated there and talking to people. So I just want to release the blessing. Remember, today was our fasting and we prayed for God to destroy every evil garment. Every evil garment. Every evil garment. Every evil garment of shame, darkness, afflictions, sorrows, whatever it is that was on us, that we were wearing, that we were putting on, the Lord is taking it away from us and replenishing it with something great and mighty in our lives. Can I hear somebody say amen to Jesus? Can I hear somebody say amen to Jesus? Can I hear somebody say amen to Jesus? Just go ahead and share. Go ahead and share and invite your friends, your families, your loved ones. You want them to be blessed. It is Christmas. There is nothing you can really give to the Lord. There is nothing you can really give. There's nothing you can offer to the Lord. The Lord needs your sacrifice of praise, your heart of worship. The Lord needs your praise. The Lord needs your thank. Just thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yesterday, we had a bad news. A friend's husband went to work. He fell down. And that was the end of his life. Right now, the family is anticipating how they are going to take their cubs back to Nigeria. Right now, people are having their black nights. Right now, as we speak, some people are in the hospital. Right now, as I talk to you, some people are being fed through pipes, tubes. Right now, as I speak to you, people are homeless on the streets. When I got into the airport, I saw a guy, he was begging for money. Only God knows how many years he's been in US. And his family are saying, oh, he's doing pretty well. They don't even know that he has gone, he's become addicted to drugs. He's become addicted to marijuana. But you look at you and me. What have we given to God? Nothing. But it's been faithful to us. Somebody just go ahead and share the video. When you share the video, just tell the Lord, thank you. You share the video, you tell the Lord, thank you. It's been worthy. It's been faithful. It's been precious. He is great. There is none like God. Look around you. Look around you. Look around you. Look around you. Innocent children are suffering. These ones are innocent. Let's forget me and you who are engaging, who are involving in fornication, adultery, lies, stealing. How about the innocent kids who have just been born into the world, who knows nothing, who have offended nobody, but they are going through a lot. How about those ones? What are you gonna say? I always want to give you the reason to worship. I always want to give you a reason to be grateful to God. I always want to give you a reason to be thankful. I want to give you another day to look up to God and say, you know what? You are worthy, Lord. If not for anything, for the gift of life. Somebody go ahead and share. Invite your friends to be blessed. Invite your family members to be blessed. And the Lord God will tremendously reward you. Remember what I always say. Evangelism, soul winning, is the heartbeat of God. If you want to please God, the Bible speaking says, when a man's way pleases the Lord make it even his own enemies to be at peace with him. So when your ways please the Lord tonight, the Lord will get to the camp of the enemy and begin to release your blessings. The Lord will get to the hands of your enemies and snatch your prosperity. When your ways pleases the Lord. Today I'm just going to come and bless you. Today I'm coming to bless you. I'm bringing you blessings. That's what I said. I just want to bless you tonight. Tonight, I'm coming to bless you because I'm in a strange land. I want a strange miracle to take place in your heart. I want a strange healing to happen right now, instantly. A lady was watching last night, and she went to bed, and she had a dream, and I shared it on the broadcast. I was doing this for God yesterday. I got to the airport today, and the devil wanted to disgrace himself. The devil began to show up his stinking head. The devil began to show up his smelling body. And I said, how dare you? How dare you? How dare you? I came prepared. I am ready for you. And I stood aside and I began to pray. I didn't even pray aloud. I just told the Lord, have your way. And I began to speak in tongues. And when I was done, I came back and I said, can you give it just one more chance? He did again and called, and the call went through. Somebody said, may the name of the Lord be blessed. If you know your God will do great and mighty. Your God will show strong and great for you. If you want a big God, you gotta have a big faith. If you want a big miracle, you gotta embrace a big God. There is nothing our God cannot do. There is nothing. The devil has showed up in so many ways today, trying to get me angry and frustrated. I just keep laughing. The Holy Spirit keeps telling me, you are on a battlefront. You just gotta remain calm. And I kept taking it in. I kept taking it in. I kept taking it in. And when I've assumed so much, I just give it up. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Have you gotten to that stage in your life that something happened and you begin to say to God, thank you, Jesus, instead of finding faults, instead of accusing, instead of blaming? Yesterday, I was talking to somebody. How do you love God? I love God so much that I told to God, I'm giving you my Mondays, my Tuesday, my Wednesday, my Thursday, my Friday, my Saturday, my Sunday. I gave it all to God. I said, take it, take it, take it, take it. How do you love God? How do you love God? How do you love God? What have you given to God? I gave God my Mondays, my Tuesdays, my Wednesday, my Thursday, my Friday, my Saturday, my Sunday. And I can never see shame. What have you given to God? What have you given to God? Go ahead and share. Go ahead and share. I'm coming to bless you. I'm going to bless you tonight real quick. I'm going to bless you tonight real quick. I'm going to bless you tonight real quick. The blessings of the Lord is wonderful. The Lord is so good. 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 I didn't be a liar not to admit that the Lord is good. God bless you as you tune in. God bless you. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you're watching from. I love you guys so much with the love of God. God bless you. If you're wondering where you are the heaven family. In this family, we do not lack. In this family, we do not lament. In this family, the Lord is great and mighty. The Lord shows forth for us whenever we call on him. With a pure heart, with humility, with a steadfast spirit, the Lord shows up for us. So somebody, if you're just tuning in, go ahead and share. Go ahead and share. Go ahead and share. Yesterday, the Lord had so many people from all over the world, and I was so like, goodness me. You know where we all watch from? So many different parts of the world. Go ahead and share. Go ahead and share. I'm just doing some invites myself. God bless you. If it is your first time for tuning in, my name is Kate Favor Omorin, a born-again Christian, the first lady for God, the only first lady of God. You are not at the wrong place. You're not here by accident. The Lord brought you for your blessings. The Lord brought you for your miracle. The Lord brought you for you to know the truth. The Lord brought you for you to be delivered. The Lord brought you for you to be saved. And above all, the Lord brought you for you to make heaven at last. The Lord brought you to make heaven at last. So if you're just wondering, if you've been looking for where you're gonna receive from the Lord, then you are at the right place. But if you do not want to receive, please do not be here, because no matter how you do not believe, it's still gonna happen to you. So if you don't want a miracle, do not be here. But if you're looking for where you're gonna be blessed, remain here and you're gonna be blessed. But if you're not looking for where you're gonna be blessed, I challenge you and I want to encourage you at the same time that if you're here, I don't care how many times the devil has afflicted your life. I don't care how many times the devil has walked on your star. I don't care how many times the devil has put and crowned you the garment of disgrace, shame, poverty. the Lord is going to remove that garment of shame and crown you with a garment of honor, wealth, prosperity, beauty, peace, favor, unmerited grace all over you. I see blessings everywhere. I see blessings. Tonight I said I'm coming to declare. I want to bless you. If you haven't shared the video, go ahead and share. You know what moves me, right? You guys want me to get to that realm. You got to move me to bring the blessings for you. When I was 3,000 feet high on the sky, as I was coming, I was just imagining. I was looking at the sky. And I started to get so amazed by the handwork of God. I said, wow, I left Canada with so much snow. Everywhere was icy. And here I am, and everywhere is dry. And I begin to imagine the greatness of God. And when I was on the sky halfway, then it was raining. I began to tell the Lord, this is showers of blessings. I began to rain the showers of blessing on you guys. I began to pray. My list is with me everywhere. I pull my list and I began to pray, calling your names one after the other. Using the videos, I'm blessing everybody. Whether the devil likes it or not, you must be blessed. Whether the devil likes it or not, you must be delivered. Whether the devil likes it or not, you must be blessed. Whether you like it yourself, the Lord is going to bless you. The Lord will forever bless you. I don't care how many people have deceived you. I don't care how many people have lied to you. I don't care how many people you spent your money to. But I'm telling you something, that the Lord is going to save you by grace, by his mercies, by his powers. The Lord is going to do it, because he says his word is yes and amen. He's a promise keeper. He's a miracle worker. He's a light in the darkness. That is who he is to us. For they that call upon him in spirit and in truth, for they that call upon him in humility, in a pure spirit, the Lord is there. He hearkens his ears and he hears them. Tears doesn't move God. I've told people, stop crying. The devil laughs at you when you cry. The devil begin to triumph and said, yes, now she's shedding tears. Now he's shedding tears. You gotta not cry for the devil. You gotta stand and tell the devil, you're a bastard. You're stupid. You're an idiot. You're a fool. When you wanna cry, just begin to tell God, Father, I thank you. Father, I give you the glory for whatever I'm going through in my life. Father, I just wanna honor you for all the sorrows, because I know they are nothing before you. Father, I just want to worship you in this sickness, because I know that at the end of my worship, I'm going to be healed. You got to tell God, Father, I have been fired, but I have not been ruined. I got a brain that I worked for this job. No matter how much they send me, I'm going to be hired again in another job. You got to know how to tap from your throne of grace. You got to know how to tap into the kingdom of God. You got to know how to steal from God. You've got your husband, you know his weakness, you know how to get from him. You got to know what moves God. When you want to get something from God, you say, Daddy, you know something? I am going to evangelize to 16 people. And at the end of my evangelism, I want you to give me the fruit of the womb. I want you to bless me with that marriage. I want you to bless me. 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 I see the Lord blessing people. I'm not started. I want you to go ahead and share and share and share. God bless you for loving God. The Lord loves you right back. The Lord loves you right back. You've got no idea how much the Lord loves you. He loves you. His arms are always open wide for you to come into his presence. He's going to give to you tonight according to your heart desires. Whether you believe it or not, the Lord is visiting you tonight. Whether you believe it or not, the Lord is blessing you tonight. Somebody go ahead and share if you haven't shared. I am just doing my shares. Go ahead and share. I'm sharing in groups. I'm sharing in Messenger. I'm sharing to everywhere. You got to take the evangelism of God to the world. There is somebody out there who hasn't heard the word, I love you, in 3 months. Bring them. Let me begin to tell them I love them. My motto is loving all people to Jesus. My mission on earth is loving all people to Jesus. I'm gonna love you to Jesus. If nobody has ever loved you, I'm gonna love you to Jesus. My love for you is pure. My love for you is real. My love for you is genuine. I don't fake it when I say I love you. I love you. And you can't do anything about it. It's a choice. It's a life I've chosen to live, to love you. Because my Bible commands me to love. It says, of all things, be at peace. Let brotherly love continue. Let sisterly love continue. So loving you is a personal decision I made for God. And since I started loving you, a lot of things have happened in my life that you've got no idea about. Spread love. Show love. The season to show love is here. You can love without giving. You can give without loving, but you can never love without giving. If anybody loves you and they have never given a thing to you, they don't love you. Because even your enemy can bless you with a gift. You can give without loving, but you cannot love without giving. So the first demonstration for love is give. The Bible speaking says, for God so loved the world that he gave. It's because God loved us. That's why he gave his only begotten son to come and die for us. So anybody that loves you and cannot give does not love you. The first demonstration that Jesus did on the cross was to give his life for us, even whilst we were yet sinners. So the first demonstration is love. If you love me, you're going to share the gospel of God, because you know I want to be in love with her. And I know that she's crazy for God. I'm Jesus freak. If you love God, you have killed my heart. If you love God, I'm in love with you. But aside of that, there's no way to my heart. The only way to my heart is through Jesus. Somebody praise the Lord tonight. Somebody bless the Lord tonight. Somebody just go ahead and tell the Lord, thank you, Jesus. I want you to go ahead and tell the Lord, thank you, Jesus. I want you to go ahead and tell the Lord, thank you, Jesus. I want you to go ahead and tell the Lord, thank you, Jesus. Savior, God bless you. As you tune in, go ahead and share the broadcast. And then say, God bless you. As you tune in, go ahead and share. William, go ahead and share. Go ahead and share, go ahead and share, go ahead and share, go ahead and share. It's going to be a wonderful moment. I'm coming to release the blessings of God upon your life. I'm coming to bless your week. I'm coming to bless the remaining days of this month, so that when people are in the hospital, you are going to be in your house rejoicing. Nobody's going to run helter-skelter because of you. And you are not going to run helter-skelter because of your loved ones. Sorry, I'm joking. God bless us. God bless us. God bless us. I'm losing my voice. The devil is a liar. God bless us. Just go ahead and share. If you haven't shared, you're the one keeping me. You're the one keeping me. I made a promise to myself. I said, I'm not going to take more than an hour. So if you can release me, I'll release you. If not, we are going to be here together. So you go ahead and share. God bless you, Savior, for sharing. It doesn't matter. You want the Lord to bless you 10 times. Share 10 times. You know something? Sometimes I don't want to pick my phone, but some people are so aggressive, right? They just keep calling. They just keep calling, 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 calling. And there's no how you see they call more than twice that you're not going to pick, right? When the call keeps coming, then you're going to pick. So if you keep sharing, 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 the person that doesn't want to join us is going to pick the phone and say, what are they up to? What are they doing? Let me join them. Go ahead and shake. Keep sharing, keep sharing. Okay? Keep sharing, keep sharing. Keep sharing. God bless you. Keep sharing. 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 God bless you. Keep sharing. As you share, God bless you. The Lord sees you. The Lord sees you as you share tonight. The Lord sees you as I have refused to eat something because I want to bless him. After blessing you, I'm going to eat. I refuse to eat something until I bless you. I refuse to eat something until I bless you. And it's already past 11 p.m. in the night. So you gotta be quick. So I go and eat something. I gotta bless you before I eat something. I gotta bless you before I eat something. I bring you blessings. I bring you blessings tonight. Nothing else but blessings. Go ahead and share. Go ahead and share. Go ahead and share. God bless you. Go ahead and share. 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 Anytime I lose my voice, that's when I want to sing for the Lord. I want to tell the devil that he's stupid. I want to tell the devil that he's stupid. I want to tell the devil that he's a bastard. How many of us hate the devil? I hate the devil. I hate the devil. Sometimes I feel that I could come in contact with the devil physically. Ha, my goodness, I would use all my strength, all my energy, all my effort, ha, all my ability. I will use it and fight the devil, and I know that the fight is gonna be the last. If I ever see the devil personally, I keep looking for the bastard. You know something about the devil? He's a coward. The devil fights behind you. He doesn't come in front of you and fight you physically. Sometimes I wish the devil can come physically and we pour acid, kerosene, gas on him and burn him. But he doesn't come because he knows he's a coward. He fights behind. Somebody, where can we find the devil? Where can we find the bastard? And bury him once and for all. I'm tired of dealing with this crap. I'm tired of dealing with the crap that the devil puts on every time. Every time he comes with different tricks. You know, if we have demonstrated our love for God the way the devil is persistent. The devil is so persistent. He never gives up. He's never tired. Like, he's not fed up. The devil does not mind fighting from morning till night. Like, he just keeps waiting somewhere. You're done with one, he puts in the next one. Rama Shantarabaskaya. Yeah. Sometimes I wish. I will still leave a note. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Welcome as you tune in. Go ahead and share for me. If you don't want to share for the Lord, share for me. If you don't want to share for the Lord, share for me. When you share for the Lord, you share for me, you share for my pretty face. Go ahead and share. Go ahead and share. Somebody go ahead and share. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. God bless you as you tune in. I'm just waiting for more people to come because I keep on holding on for you guys. I keep on holding on for you guys. But a day will come. You guys will come. And I am gone. And you guys will say, what happened? She always holds on for us. And I'm like, yeah, I'm not going to keep sitting here and shouting, share, share, share the video, share the video, share the video. No. So one day I will come and I will sit and I'll tell the Holy Spirit, today is me and you. And we are done and we go. God bless us. God bless us. God bless us. I thank God for a safe trip. I thank God for a safe flight. I thank God for joining mercies. The Lord has been wonderful. The devil showed up in so many ways, but the Lord is victorious. The devil tried everything humanly possible for me not to get to this land. Ha! But I declared and I decree and I told the devil, you know something? I knew I was ahead. Ha! Somebody, it's good for you to have the Holy Spirit filled in you. Ha! I knew the devices of the enemy and I began to tell you a week before my joining. I said, begin to pray for US trip. I didn't know the prayer was for something. When the Holy Spirit begins to tell you something, don't hold on. I said, somebody, can you pray for US trip? You guys were praying. You guys were praying. It's your prayer that has made it possible for me to sit today. Probably if we have not started praying ahead of time, the devil would have had his way. So do not be ignorant about the devices of the devil. You gotta have the Holy Spirit filled in you. The Bible speaking says, commit thy ways and everything that you want to do. Acknowledge the Lord. I was telling a guy to create a page for me. And he went ahead and he chose a name. And he came to me and he said, woman of God, I'm done with the page. And I said, who gave you the name? He said, the system picked the name for me. I said, no, I do not walk in the flesh. Whatever it is, the Spirit did not say, I do not operate. That is not how I started. Do not spoil things for me. Somebody, you gotta be in the Spirit, day in, day out. Because the enemy doesn't sleep. Why would you sleep? It's an heavenly rest. You gotta fight. You gotta wake up. You gotta fall down. You gotta struggle. You gotta climb. You gotta keep kicking until you see your Savior. Somebody, continue to share the video. As you share, people are coming in. As you share, people are coming in. As you share, people are coming in. I thank the Lord for giving us victory tonight. I thank the Lord for making His face to shine for us. For those of you that fasted, may the Lord bless you. For those of you that waited on the Lord today, 6 to 12, may the Lord remove every garment of shame from you. every garment of shame that was generational is hereby taken from you. Every disgrace that was paternal is hereby taken from you. Every maternal shame is hereby taken from you. The one that they have covenanted and kept before you were born, right from time immemorial, is hereby taken from you. Ah, the Lord has taken out the garment of shame and is putting on a new garment of glory, a new garment of favor, a new garment of open doors, a new garment of divine health, healing, miracles, signs and wonders, financial breakthroughs. The Lord is putting that garment on you. A garment that will attract people in the society for you. A garment that will bring you good news. A garment that will bring you joy. A garment that will settle you. Ah, the Lord will settle somebody. I hear the Lord says, I will settle somebody tonight. I am settling somebody tonight. I pray that that somebody be me in Jesus' name. I pray that as the Lord is saying, I will settle someone tonight, may it be me in Jesus' name. Ah, as I'm saying, as I hear the Lord says, I will settle somebody tonight, let it be me. Ah, Father, it doesn't matter if it is 50 people that you want to settle tonight. Lord, may I be one of them. The Lord says, I am going to settle somebody tonight. I am going to settle somebody tonight. I'm trying to share. I'm going to share. I'm going to keep sharing. I'm going to keep sharing. I'm going to keep sharing until Facebook say you can share no more. Every night I come on, this is what I do. I share more than 150 videos, 120 videos, 80 videos. Now tell me. Tell me why the Lord will not bless me. No, as a human being, judge my efforts and think of what God thinks about me. Every night, no matter how tired I am, I come here and I pray for people. My Bible makes me to understand that when Job prayed for his friends, Job did not pray for himself. So when you pray for people, when you cultivate an habit of praying for people, the Lord takes away your own burdens easily. When Job prayed for his friend, his latter end greatly increased. Meaning that what Job had was nothing compared to the blessings that the Lord later gave to Job. That's what it means. So when you share the broadcast of Jesus, it's not in vain. When you come for us to pray together, you see the testimonies that people are having every day. Who is the maker of all these things? God. God. People see us, they are laughing. They think we are stupid. They think we don't know anything. They are not better than us. Some of them are not even as pretty as we are. Some of them are not even as educated as we are. But because we know that no man seeks the Lord and remains the same, we continue to seek the Lord. 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 And when the Lord shows forth for us, people will begin to say, we have gone to do black magic. We have gone to do juju. We have gone to do this. We have gone to do that. They will never remember our every night on this broadcast. Ah, when the Lord blesses us and an enemy comes to attack us and begin to destroy us, may they die under their destruction in the mighty name of Jesus. Whoever will begin to destroy you after the blessings of the Lord will meet the arrow of God to strike them in the mighty name of Jesus. People are out to destroy. I want you to know that the time is now where people will begin to condemn, where people will begin to judge, where people will bring into mockery the things of God, the people of God. I want you to stand as a Christian and not be part of them. When you see people begin to talk about the men of God and the women of God, distance yourself because they are already cursed. The Bible says by so doing, you are heaping coals of fire on your head. You are heaping coals of fire on your head. The Bible led me to understand, when you see your brother falling, when you see your brother falling, you cannot tell him, brother, come back. You start laughing, you start gossiping. Is that the love that you came down to Jesus? Show me the love that you came down to Jesus. Show me the love that you came down to Jesus. Show me the love that you came down to Jesus. Is that the love that you came down to Jesus? When you see your sister falling, you cannot tell that sister come back. You start laughing, you start gossiping. Is that the love that you came down to Jesus? Show me the love that you came down to Jesus. Show me the love that you came down to Jesus. Show me the love that you came down to Jesus. Is that the love that you came down to Jesus? When you see your brother falling, you cannot tell him, brother, come back. You start laughing, you start gossiping. Is that the love that you came down to Jesus? Where is the love that you came down to Jesus? Where is the love that you came down to Jesus? Where is the love that you came down to Jesus? Is that the love that you came down to Jesus? You see, your brother is falling. You see, your sister is falling. Instead of you to go and ask them, brother, why are you backsliding? Sister, why are you backsliding? You begin to laugh. You said, I knew that one day they will stop this, their Facebook life. I knew that one day they will not come up again. I knew that one day they will fake. Is that the love that you came down to Jesus? Is that the love that you're showing as a Christian? Is that the love that you're showing like somebody that loves God? May the Lord have mercy on us in Jesus' mighty name. Go ahead and share. Whatever the Spirit speaks in my heart today, whatever the Spirit puts in my heart tonight is what I'm going to say. Whatever it is the Spirit brings on my lips, that's what I'm going to say. I said I'm coming to bless. But whatever the Spirit brings, I'm going to throw in. This is how I flew. This is how I flew. This is how I flew. Whatever the Spirit says to me, I give to you. Whatever I receive from the throne of grace, I do not keep it. I don't know how to filter words. This is my problem. I have had a lot of enemies because I don't know how to filter words. I don't know how to pretend. I don't know how to hide. When the Lord gives me a prophecy for you, I say it to you the way it is. Raw grace. That's the kind of anointing I have. So raw. Sometimes it's not pleasing. You know, one day the Lord gave me a word. One day the Lord gave me a word. I was sitting and I was talking to people and all of a sudden the Lord gave me a word. And I began to cry and I was sobbing and I was sobbing because I knew the word was for me. I was so guilty, but I accepted it because I knew it was my weakness. And I began to sit there crying and tell the Lord, Father, give us help. Father, give us help. Father, give us help, for the help of men is vain. For the help of man is vain. Father, give us help. Give us help in times of trouble. Give us help in times of sickness. Give us help in times of tribulation. For the help of man is vain. May the Lord send you your helpers in Jesus' mighty name. May the Lord send your helpers in Jesus' mighty name. As soon as Facebook tells me I cannot share again, I'm going to stop. I'm going to start. For now, I'm going to keep sharing until Facebook blocks me. This is what I do every night. I share the video of God because I want the Lord to bless me 10 times, 20 times, 50 times, 100 times. I keep sharing. I keep sharing. I am not ashamed of God. I want people to see and know that I love God. I want the enemy. Even my enemy knows that I love God. My friend knows that I love God. My family knows that I love God. Even at work, they know that I love God. I'm ready for you to fire me if you tell me that I'm not going to pray at my work. I don't give a damn about anybody if not God. It's my focus. It's my first. It's my beginning. It's my last. I love God. I declare every day that I love God because I am proud of whom I love. I know the God I save. And I can stand anywhere and decree and declare that I love God. And every day I come alive, I say, Lord, if I will leave your grace tomorrow, to go and seek for other gods, kill me today. If I will leave your grace tomorrow to go and look for little gods, kill me today. Don't allow me to fall out of grace. If I will leave your grace to go and look for crowds, look for million viewers, look for miracle, kill me today. Don't allow me to live till tomorrow and go to hellfire. The Bible speaks and says, what shall it profit you? If you live the whole of your life on earth and at the end of the day lose your soul, what shall it profit you? What shall it profit you? What? 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 Come to the one that can save your body. Come to the one that can save your soul. Come to the one. You guys should be nice to me. If you haven't shared the video, go ahead and share. So we start. Go ahead and share. You're the one keeping me. I'm waiting for you to share. Then I can start. Begin to rain the blessings of God on you tonight. I came to bless you. I came to bless you. For those of you that fasted and prayed and waited on the Lord, may the Lord bless you. This week, I'm mostly going to be on fasting. I'm mostly going to be on fasting this week. If you want to join me, you can join me. I'm mostly going to be on fasting. Tomorrow, I'm going to repeat the same fasting. Doesn't matter. Whatever you can do, you can do. You can do 6 to 9 to 6. You can do 12 to 6. Like, you can start 12 midnight to 6 a.m. in the morning. You can start 6 a.m. in the morning to 9 a.m. in the morning. You can start 9 a.m. in the morning to 12 in the noon. 12 in the noon to 6 in the evening. Whatever you can do, just key in and fast. Key in and fast. I want you to fast. I want you to fast. I want you to fast. Make sure you feed your soul. When you fast, you're feeding your soul and your spirit. A prayerful Christian is the one that fasts, that prays. A prayerful Christian fasts all the time. When you fast all the time, the Lord empowers you. You have grace. You speak a thing, it comes to pass because you have killed your body and you feed your soul, your spirit all the time. So the flesh no longer deals, no, cannot operate. You have made no provision for the flesh. You're living in the spirit. The Lord is occupying your mind, your thoughts. I began to drive from the airport to the house. I keep saying to the Lord, thank you, Jesus. I keep saying to the Lord, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Make it an habit. Let people know you for your love for God. Let people know you for the good things. So that even when you leave this world, your children will say, I know my mom is in heaven with God. Your husband will say, I know my wife is with God. Your wife will say, I know that my husband is with the Lord right now. Live a life of legacy. Now, when you leave the world, your name will remain for the good things. People will remember your words. People will remember your encouragement. People will remember your love. People will remember your kindness. People will remember what you live for. Rama Shantaradabo Shantaradabo Skaya Kaya. People will remember the ways that the Lord used you to touch their lives. Like, it will take people years to recover. You know something? My ex still calls me on the phone. My ex. They still call me up to today from the phone and begin to tell me that they cannot find somebody to replace me. And I begin to tell them that's just the beginning. I have no replica. Not even my siblings. My own parents that brought us to this world will sit down and tell my siblings and says, there is nobody like this, my daughter. She is different. Sometimes I sit down and I ask God, why did you give me this daughter? We do not deserve her. Have you ever had friends who would sit down and tell you, please, I would rather lose anything than lose you in my life. You gotta impact someone's life to that level of living a remarkable life that people cannot recover when you walk out of their life. They can never recover. Live that life. Live that life. Unless you have never come in contact with me, there is something that you always look forward to. You gotta live that life. And you can only live it through Christ. It's only in Christ that you have a pure love. A love that is under no condition. A love that is without option. Not what you stand to gain, but what you do for people for the blessings of God. The sacrifice you make for people because of God. The love you give to people because that is what the Holy Spirit demands you to do. Not for what you stand to gain in returns. No. 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 I would rather do something for people who cannot reward me than those who can reward me, because by so doing, I have taken my reward already. But when I give to an old woman who can never pay me back, even if it would take her 50 years of her life to sell her things for her to be able to pay me. You know something? People always say, once you're blessed, you are blessed. When the Lord blesses you, you do things for God, not for people. This is how you get your reward. This is how the Lord enlarges your territory. You guys don't want to share the video, you just want to keep listening to me, right? No problem. I'm going to keep sharing and I'm going to keep talking until I'm told by Facebook that I cannot share again. And then I'm going to start and pray for you. Tonight I'm coming to bless you. I'm not coming to say anything. I just bring you blessings from the Lord. I bring you blessings from the Lord. I want to bless you because the Lord gave me a safe flight. The Lord made me to land in Houston, Texas. Safe and sound. You guys did not hear that the woman of God was stranded. You guys did not hear that the woman of God was returned at the airport because her name was spelled wrongly. Because her name was incomplete. Two names. I have three names. Two names. Even the two names, one was wrong. The devil is a liar. When the devil wants to, when the devil knows that somebody is about to be delivered, the devil would fight it with everything. I foresaw it. And I kept telling you, pray that God should have his way in the U.S. Pray. When you pray for somebody, when you pray, somebody, you got to be in the spirit. You got to be ahead in spirit to see ahead of time. When I was saying pray for the U.S., I'm sure the devil was not happy. The devil was like, she has come again. And I'm sure the devil is sad right now saying, wow, so she made it. This lady, for my sake, you shall not stay under affliction for anymore. For my sake, you will not remain in bondage anymore. For my sake, the Lord is setting you loose from wherever you were tied. For my sake, I hear the chain breaking from your necks, from your hands, from your legs. For my sake, I stand in the land of this U.S., and I decree and I prophesy in your life, whatever it is that was not working for you, wherever it is that you were cut short and you were limited in grace, today as I sit in this strange land, I speak in your life. Until the enemy that attacks you can get to another strange land, the enemy cannot counter your blessings tonight. Rama Shantarabo Shankarabaskaya. The enemy cannot counter your blessings tonight. I come with anointing. I cover this broadcast with the precious blood of the Lamb. I release the harrow from heaven on this platform right now. I release the harrow from the heaven on this broadcast right now. I receive harrow and I release it on this broadcast. Every evil spirit, every monitoring spirit, I hereby burn your cameras. I hereby destroy your cameras. I hereby destroy your cameras. I hereby destroy your cameras. You will not come in contact. You're not going to use anybody as a point of contact to tap into this moment. I destroy every power from the pit of hell and the power of darkness that are moving around, that are wanting to have their way in this arena. I flee the blood of Jesus, the power of the Holy Spirit, fire of the Holy Spirit, arrow of the Holy Spirit. I release machete from heaven that anybody that dares the spirit tonight will be machete to death in Jesus' mighty name. We're going to have a testimony tomorrow hearing people say, I lost somebody. I lost somebody. I lost somebody. I lost somebody. You just got to thank God because no good person will fall like that. The Lord will break down every evil person. Whoever said you will not see the remaining of this year will go for you to survive. Whoever said you will not make it, the remaining of this year, you will be in the Lord is using them for a replacement for you. Whoever said you will not stand to see the end of this year, the Lord is replacing them for your sake. Whoever said whatever it is that was declared and decreed, I hereby stand as a servant of the Most High God, and I destroy that everything that was not made and said from the Lord cannot stand in your life. The Bible speaking says, it shall not stand, neither will it come to pass. Every evil plan of the devil in our lives is hereby thwarted. In Jesus' mighty name, I declare. Amen. If you haven't shared the video, go ahead and share. I've not forgotten about share. I'm going to tell you to share the video until you share. You got to share this broadcast. If you haven't shared the broadcast, go ahead and share the broadcast. You cannot cheat the Holy Spirit. Go ahead and share the broadcast. I open this arena. I open this section in the name of God the Father. I open the section in the name of God the Son. I open the section in the name of God the Holy Spirit. I bless you in the name of God the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Wherever you're watching from, you're welcome in the name of God the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. I cover you with the blood of Jesus. I cover you with the precious blood of Jesus. I release the fire of God wherever you are. I release the anointing of God wherever you are. I cover you with the layer of a lamb. I cover you. I release fire. I release matchet. I release arrow on this broadcast right now. That the Lord will walk in majesty. That the Lord will walk in a way that it pleases him. That the Lord will bring blessings your way. That the Lord will locate you tonight and favor you. That it has, your time to be delivered has come. Your time to be blessed is now. Your time to you to receive your breakthrough is now. Now I'm gonna minister to the Lord and then we start. I'm gonna minister to the Lord before we start. Anytime I lose my voice, I use it to sing to the Lord and it comes back. I'm gonna sing to the Lord and then we start. We're gonna be really low. I want you to be in the spirit. I want you to be in the spirit. I want you to key in. I want you to believe. I want you to trust God. I want you to see God a second time on the cross of Calvary. Just begin to figure that the Lord is hanging on the cross of Calvary because of you. That the Lord went all the way and received the pain, the bruises, the slaps, the vinegar. That he took it just because of you and me. And that's the reason the Lord is coming to bless you tonight, because he went too far. He went all the way. He went all the way. Yes, you are the Lord. Mosai. Yes, you are the Lord. Mosai. Yes, you are the Lord. Most High, yes, you are the Lord. Most High, yes, you are the Lord. Most High, yes, you are the Lord. Most, somebody help me sing, yes, you are the Lord. Ah, Most High, yes, you are the Lord. More, yes, you are the Lord. Yes, you are. Yes, you are, Lord. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Yes, you are the Lord. More, when I am down to nothing, yes, you are. Yes, you are, Lord. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Go ahead and say, yes, you are the Lord. Most High, yes, you are the Lord. Most High, yes, you are the Lord. More, when I am down to nothing, yes, you are. When I am sick, you are the Lord. When I am down, you are the Lord. Yes, you are the Lord. More, even on that hospital bed, yes, you are the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Most High, yes, you are the Lord. 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 Most High. So many of you, you have family members. So many of you, you have friends. So many of you, you have people that you have given your life, given your best, people that you have suffered for, people that you have loved so much. But when you needed them the most, they were not there for you. It was still the Lord. If you don't have anything to tell the Lord tonight, just tell the Lord that He is the Lord. He is the one, the Most High God, the one that make it a way where there seems to be no way. The one that has given you a chance for you to live and see today. The one that has made it possible for you to be knowledgeable, to be wise, to be healthy, to be happy. The one that has given you a reason to still stand despite the storms of life. It is that one that I'm telling you to give Him the glory and say, Lord, yes, You are the Lord Most High. I want somebody to go ahead and tell the Lord, You are the Lord Most High. Just two people to tell the Lord, yes, You are the Lord Most High. Lord, I worship You because You are the Lord Most High. Declare that He is the one that is the Lord Most High. Declare that in your business, He has been the one that is the Lord Most High. Declare that in your family, in the lives of your children, in your work, in your going out and your coming in, that it's been the Lord that is the Most High God. Declare and decree and tell the Lord, Father, God bless you, Christina. Every night I come in, I always tell the Lord. If the word is for somebody, you got to bring that person to hear the word. Every night I come on, there is somebody that is the reason for my coming on. Tonight was for Christina. That is me. I'm going to read what she says. That is me. I'm going through that. You already know, woman of God, I want to be obedient to God's word. Some people are still disobedient. Even as we speak on this broadcast, people are still disobedient to God. You tell people share, they don't want to share. You tell people do this, they don't want to do, but they want to receive. You know, sometimes I begin to wonder. I say, Lord, You got to touch the hearts of Your people, because the hearts of kings and queens is in Your hands. And You could circumcise it and turn it to be something that is going to make it to be profitable. I don't want you to come to the presence of the Lord and go empty-handed. I don't want you to come in and go the way you came. If you don't want the blessings of God, that's why you got to call somebody else who needs it to come and receive. Even when you were disobedient, the Lord is the Most High God. Even when you were not there, even when you refused, the Lord was the Most High God. You got to fear God, people of God. The Bible speaks and says, what's the old duty of a man? In the book of Ecclesiastes, it says, yet to see the conclusion of the old matter. Fear God and keep His commandments. You got to fear God. When you fear God, you got to keep His commandments. When you love God, you got to love Him and fear Him and respect Him and be obedient to Him. If you love your husband, you love your wife, so you got to be obedient to them, right? Because you want the love to continue. Some people always have that problem to share on it. The Lord says your heart that you want to share, but you cannot share. That's fine. God bless you for your effort. God bless you for attempting. Monta, I bless you. God bless you for attempting to share. Okay, so we are not going to take any more time. I'm going to pray for you and I'm going to close the section. God bless us. 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 The Lord will not put your heart to shame. The Lord that brought you tonight has a thing for you, has a blessing for you. The Lord that brought you tonight has a better plans for you. The Lord that brought you tonight knows that His thoughts for you are of good and not of evil, to give you an expected end. The Bible speaking says, of all things that thou mayest prosper us and stay in good health. We're going to close our Monday fasting, and then I'm going to bless you for today. Let us pray. My Father and my Maker, the one that nourished everything, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Father, I bless Your name. Father, I worship You. Father, I give You the glory. I give You the honor. I give You the adoration. For who You are, for what You are, and for what You would be. Father, I stand amazed in Your presence tonight, because You are awesome. Lord, You are powerful. You are wonderful. You are fantastic. There is none like you. We have searched within our friends, our neighbors, our parents, our siblings. There is none like you. Father, we thank you for the grace that you have given to us. We thank you for the energy, the ability that you've made it possible for us to gather once again. Not as the world gathers, but as your children gathers in your presence, Lord, to receive from you. Father, we have come together to say thank you for all the things that you have done, for sustaining our life, because life each day is a gift. So many people have gone. They are wishing that they could have another chance, Lord, to come and live. But it's not possible. But here we are standing. Here we are singing. Here we are praising. Here we are praying. Father, we thank you for not falling out of your grace. We thank you for the grace that you have made for us to remember you tonight. Lord, we say thank you. To everything that you have done, Lord, we say thank you. To everything that you did, Lord, we say thank you. To everything that you will do, Lord, we are saying thank you. We give you the glory, we give you the honor in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we bless your name for making it possible for us to wait in your presence, for making it for us to come out, Lord, and pray. Father, the fasting, the prayer point was that the garment of shame is destroyed. Father, every garment of shame that we were wearing right from when our parents gave birth to us, the one that we wore when we got into primary school, the one that we wore in our secondary school, the garment of shame that we wore in our universities, the one that we picked up from the place of worship, the one that we picked up from the neighborhood, the one that we picked up from one place or the other, the one that we picked up from auntie's or uncle's house, the one that we picked up from our friend's house. Father, we plead the fire of the Holy Ghost to burn every evil garment. Every evil garment of sickness. Every evil garment of sorrow. Every evil garment of torture, delay, poverty, failure. Sickness. We remove such garments. We remove the garment of sorrow in the name of God the Father. We remove the garment of shame in the name of God the Son. And we remove the garment of delay in the name of God the Holy Spirit. Father, and we put it in the everlasting fire that burns from heaven right now and says this garment will never arise again in our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, right now, by the grace that is upon my life, by the unction, by the authority that you've given to me, I totally... In totality, Lord, I totally, Lord, with a broken spirit, with humility in my heart, with a sober spirit, Lord, I put my hand in the throne of grace, Lord, and I receive a brand new garment, and I put it on your children on this broadcast, Lord. I put my hands on the throne of grace and I receive a brand new garment and I put it on your children on this broadcast. I put my hands again, Lord, in your throne of grace and I receive a brand new garment of praise, of blessings, of favor, of open doors, of healings, of deliverance, of marriages, of settlements, of wealth, of a sound spirit, of joy, of love, of happiness, Lord. And I wear it on your children right now in the mighty name of Jesus. And I said, may this garment, may this new garment be permanent in their lives. May this garment be permanent in their lives. May this garment, Lord, be permanent in their heart. Any evil friend, any evil neighbor, any evil parent, any evil pastor, any evil prophet, Lord, that will arise to afflict this new garment, may they die by the fire of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' mighty name. Anybody that will arise, Lord, to attack the new garment of praise that you've given to your children right now, Lord, may your arrows strike them to death. Anybody that will arise to attack your children with the new garment that you've given to them, may your machete from the Holy Ghost strike them, cut them, machete them to death in Jesus' mighty name. Whoever says that they cannot wear this garment and be happy, Lord, may this garment of sorrow return and be their portion in the mighty name of Jesus. Whoever says that we cannot smile, Lord, may they drink our tears for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Whoever says that we cannot live to see better days, Father, may they live in our sorrows for the rest of their life in Jesus' mighty name. The Bible speaks and says, whatever you wish somebody, so shall happen to you. Whatever is the wishes of people in our life, Father, may so be their portions in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for the blessings that you've given to us in this fasting section. And we say, Lord, may those blessings be permanent. Even as people that would remember to key in next week, Lord, may the blessings be permanent. Father, we pray for the grace for your children to be able to wait and seek your face every other Monday till your return in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, right now we open this arena with the precious blood of the Lamb in the name of God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And we call on the fire of the Holy Spirit to come and dwell with us in this new section. Father, as we gather tonight to invoke the presence of God, Father, as we gather tonight to call the blessings on your children, Father, I call on you that you descend with your angels right now. I descend, I pray for your seven angels that walk with me to come down right now at this throne in the mighty name of Jesus. In this arena, in this atmosphere, in this hour, Lord, I pray that your angels will begin to walk face by face, name by name, location by location, and rain blessings on your children. Father, the Bible makes me to understand that who you bless, that no man can curse. That whom you anoint, nobody can dim the anointing of the light in the life of that person. That who you have lifted, nobody can bring that person down. Father, right now, at this time in point, may he please you, Lord, to bless your children. May he bless you to uplift this one. May he bless you for you to settle this one in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil thought of any man or woman, Lord, in the hearts of people that are conceiving it, whatever it is that they are conceiving, whatever it is that they are coming in terms with, Lord, if it is not of you, may it go back to their senders in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever it is that the evil ones, that the enemies are planning, Lord, that is not of you in our lives, may it go back to our senders in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil arrow, Lord, may it go back to their senders in the mighty name of Jesus. The time has come, Lord, for you to bless your children. We know that we are not worthy, Lord. Do not allow the devil to bring us under judgment and condemnation before your throne of grace right now and begin to tell that you see they are living in disobedience, therefore they should not receive. Father, it is your grace. It is your grace. It is your grace. It is your grace. Father, I plead your grace. I plead your mercies. I plead your forgiveness, Lord, that we are not worthy. We are not righteous. We've sinned against you, Lord, in so many ways. We have offended you in diverse ways. But Lord, tonight we plead the blood of Jesus that speaketh better things than the blood of Abel, than the blood of animal, than the blood of man, than the blood of human, Lord, that your blood will speak for us tonight. Every blessings of Abraham is going to begin to work in our life. Every blessings of Sarah, Naomi, Esther is going to manifest in our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Whether the devil likes it or not, Father, you are going to bless us tonight. Because when you bless us, Lord, it cannot be compared to the blessings of the world. It cannot be compared to the blessings of any man. It cannot be compared to the blessings of any woman. It cannot be compared to the blessings of any worker. It cannot be compared to the blessings of any earthly boss. It cannot be compared to the blessings of a pastor, of a prophet, of anybody, Lord. Your blessings are pure. Your blessings are permanent. Your blessings are forever. Lord, come and bless us. In every area of our lives, Lord, we need your blessings. In our marriages, we need your blessings. In our relationship, Lord, we need your blessings. In our pregnancies, Lord, we need your blessings. In the fruits of the womb, Lord, we need your blessings. In our promotions, Lord, we need your blessings. In our jobs, Lord, we need your blessings. In our ministry, Lord, we need your blessings. In our going out and our coming in, Lord, we need your blessings. In our dealing and interacting with people every day. Lord, we need your blessings. Even as we pray, Lord, we need your blessings. As we seek your face today, Lord, we need your blessings. In every ramification of our life, Lord, we need your blessings. What is it that we can do without your blessings, Lord? Nothing. In our sleep, Lord, we need your blessings. In our dream life, Lord, we need your blessings. For us to see visions and prophesy, Lord, we need your blessings. For us to do signs and wonders, Lord, we need your blessings. What can we do? Where can we go? How can we survive without the blessings of the Lord? I am here to answer for the church that there is nothing under the sun that we can do without the blessings of God. Father, we're begging. Father, we are pleading. Father, we are interceding that you would come down to us right now with your blessings. Father, I put my hand in the heavenly kingdom and I release the basket of blessings right now on this broadcast. I release your basket of goodies on this broadcast. I release the showers of blessings that was poured on the sky today on this broadcast. I release the blessings of Houston, Texas on this broadcast, Lord. I release the blessings of the heavenly kingdom on this broadcast today. Lord, whoever is crying, whoever was living in tears, may the blessings of today wipe away every tears from their eyes. Whoever was in sickness, Lord, may your blessings tonight heal them of every disease and infirmity. Whoever was in bondage, Lord, may your blessings set them loose by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Whoever the job was lacking behind, may your blessings open new jobs, opportunities in the mighty name of Jesus. Whoever was not doing well at their job, Lord, may the blessings, Lord, may your blessings begin to rain peace and calmness in their jobs in the mighty name of Jesus. Whoever the marriage was suffering, Father, may your blessings open doors in their marriages in the mighty name of Jesus. In that relationship, Lord, may the blessings of tonight open doors in that relationship. I stand in the land of Houston, Texas, and I prophesy and I speak in your life. I decree and I declare that the wills that the ministers, the governors, the president, people in authority that are not struggling, that are not lamenting, that are not snatching their teeth, may it be your portion on this broadcast. To every viewer, the goodies of this land will begin to work in your life. The dollars of this land will begin to reign in your life. The happiness that is in this land will begin to be your passion. The way people have come to this land and they have been able to do something profitable, so shall your life be profitable in every area. In Jesus' mighty name. May the blessings for you to get your house and build your own and ride your cars and go to good schools and bring up godly kids, may it be your portion today in the mighty name of Jesus. May the blessings for you to stay in good health and prosper, may it be your portion. May the blessings for you to run that ministry, may it be your portion. I release the goodness of the land of Houston, Texas on everybody that is looking for a better life in his or her life to be your portion right now in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for you that as many that has had peace in this land, that I also give their peace to you, that the peace of the Lord will begin to reign in your homes, in your lives, in your devil, in everything that you do in your life from today henceforth in the mighty name of Jesus. I release blessings to you in the name of God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. I release blessings in your home. I release blessings in your family. I release blessings in everything that you do. In your school, I release the blessings of God. In your jobs, I release the blessings of God. In the lives of your children, I release the blessings of God. In that sickness, I release the blessings of God. In every everything that you were suffering, in every setback, I release the blessings of God. In every delay, I release the blessings of God. In every torture, I release the blessings of God. To every depressed souls, I release the blessings of God. To every evil spirit of anxiety in your life, I release the blessings of God right now. In that evil dream of yours, I release the blessings of God upon your life. In that vision that I see in your life, I release the blessings of God upon your life. In your anointing, I release the blessings of God. You're watching me, and you're supposed to sit down and be working for God the way I'm working. I release the anointing. If you're under the sound of my voice, and you have the call of God upon your life, a time will come. I release the blessings for the anointing of God to begin to flow in your life. I release the blessings of God on your anointing. I release the blessings of God on your anointing. I release the blessings of God on that anointing. You. I release the blessings of God on that anointing in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I have blessed your children that you commanded. I release the blessings of God on that womb that wants to conceive and bear fruit. I release the blessings of God upon your womb that wants to conceive and bear fruit in the mighty name of Jesus. To you that is struggling in the ministry, I release the anointing of God upon your ministry. To that autistic child, there is an autistic child. There is an autistic child. There is an autistic child. That 3 years autistic child, I release the anointing, the blessings of God upon your life, that by your next birthday, you will begin to speak like other kids. I restore you from the spirit of autism. I release, I curse that spirit of autism in you. The spirit of autism in you, I kill that spirit right now. May the blessings of the Lord come upon your life and you will begin to act and behave like other kids. I bless you. I bless your life. I rewrite a different handwriting for you. You autistic child, I release the blessings of God upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus. To every child that is going through pain, tumor, cancer, whatever it is that you're going through, I release the blessings of God upon that sickness. And I cast that sickness out of your body in the mighty name of Jesus. I release the blessings of God in your finances. I release the blessings of God in everything that you do. I release the blessings of God upon you. I release the blessings of God on your week. I release the blessings of God in this remaining days of the month. I release the blessings of God in the month of December, January, February, March, 2019, 2020. I release the blessings of God in your life going forward. There shall be no more setback. There shall be no more tears. The blessings of the Lord is locating you. The blessings of the Lord is locating you. The blessings of the Lord is locating you. The blessings of the Lord is locating you right now. The blessings of the Lord is locating you right now. Receive your blessing by fire. Receive your blessings by fire. Receive your blessings by fire. Receive your blessing by fire. Receive your blessings by fire. Whatever it is that you have in your heart for the Lord to bless you, I release blessings from a strange land, that strange things will begin to happen for you, that you will begin to experience the strange touch of God, that you begin to experience the strange blessings, strange miracles, strange signs and wonders, strange destiny helpers. May the Lord not make you to meet with any destiny killer. Because when you meet a destiny killer, the blessings of the Lord will not show forth from you. I kill every destiny deceiver, every destiny twaddlers, every destiny killers. I destroy them on your way. And I release the blessings of God on your wisdom, on your knowledge. I release the blessings of God upon you and your family. I release the blessings of God in your homes. I release the blessings of God in your vehicles. I release the blessings of God in every material of yours. I release the blessings of God on your documents. I release the blessings of God on your medical report. I release the blessings of God on your food. I release the blessings of God on those medications, that they will become the body and the blood of Christ. I release the blessings of God on people that are suffering and looking for the Lord to restore them. I release the blessings of God upon that sickness. I release the blessings of God upon that cancer. I release the blessings of God upon that broken relationship, that broken marriage. And I call forth restoration for you in the mighty name of Jesus. I release the blessings of God in your going out and your coming in. I release the blessings of God all over you. As you will sleep, as you will eat, as you will sit, as you will stand, I release the blessings of God to locate you in every area of your life in Jesus' mighty name. I release the blessings of God in your ministry. I release the blessings of God in your endeavors, your vacations, your trips. Those of you that are planning trips, I release the blessings of God on your endeavors. I release the blessings of God in that marriage plan. I release the blessings of God on that proposal. I release the blessings of God in that open doors that you're looking for. If you've gotten somebody and you are engaged, you're looking for money to seal up that which the Lord has started from you. I release blessings on your finances now. I release blessings on your hands. I release blessings. I release blessings. I release blessings in your homes. I release prosperity. I see a lot of people having their own homes. I see a lot of people with a lot of cars. I release blessings on your bills. I release blessings on your mortgages. I release blessings on your utilities. I release blessings on your debt in the mighty name of Jesus. Every debt, Lord, I release your blessings upon the sons in the mighty name of Jesus. May the good Lord bless you. May the good Lord bless you. Is there anybody that has a special need for prayer? If you know that the Lord has not touched you, the Lord has not blessed you, or the prayer is not enough for you, let me bless you personally. You have a request and you say, woman of God, I want you to bless me in this area of my life that you did not touch. Let me see you and pray with you and release the blessings of God upon you. If you know there is something I did not touch, if you know that there's something you're believing God for and it wasn't mentioned, it wasn't said, can I see you and pray for you personally? Aside of that, we are gonna close the moment. If you know there is something that you're doing, there's something that you're wanting, when I pray for you, I touch every area. I touch every area because I don't pray on my own. I pray in the Holy Ghost. The Holy Spirit knows wherever everybody has a problem, whatever is worrying people, the Holy Spirit knows. So if you know there is something that you want and I did not touch, let me pray for you personally. Let me pray for you personally. Let me pray for you personally. Is there anybody that needs a special prayer? Is there anybody that wants a special prayer? Anybody that needs a special prayer? You want a special prayer? Can I pray for you? Can I pray for you? You want a special prayer? Angela, God bless you. Angela, God bless you. Vivian, God bless you. 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 I release the blessings of God upon your life. To every viewer, I release the blessings of God upon your life. And I leave the blessings of God on this broadcast for as many as will view later. I release the blessings of God from Houston, Texas to your life. That whatever is working in the land of Houston, Texas will begin to work in your life. Wherever you are, whether you are in Dubai, you are in China, you are in Africa, you are in Ghana, you are in Nigeria, you are in Kenya, wherever you are, I release the blessings from Houston, Texas. That the Lord will touch you at the point of your need. I release the blessings of God on that lake. Savior Thomas. Savior Thomas, I'm really sorry. I was supposed to get back to you. but I've been on a journey since morning. I know you sent me voice message. I know you wrote me. I'm sorry. I will get back to you. I'll get back to you, okay? I'll get back to your place, okay? I release the blessings of God on that leg. Every evil pain on your leg, an end comes to it. When the blessing of God dwells on a thing, the devil cannot take over. I release the blessings of God in the four corners of the world, wherever you are, in the north, in the east, in the south, in the west, Europe, Africa, Italy, UK, wherever you are, in the four corners of the world, I release the blessings. Just receive it in the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody was saying, you want me to pray for what? Woman of God, pray for me. Let God guide my heart. In every decision that you're believing God for tonight, the Lord is going to give you results. The Lord is going to guide you to make that decision. The Lord is going to direct you. I send the Holy Spirit to stay with you tonight. The Bible speaking says, the Lord has left us, and he sent the Holy Spirit to remain with us as a comforter, to teach us, to guide us. Tonight, I release the Holy Spirit to be with you and help you and guide your heart to make the right decision and come out with the right solution. In Jesus' name, I release the blessings of God over your life. I release the blessings of God over your life. It is well with you. It is well with you. It is well with you, Angela. It is well with you. Tomorrow, before I come online, I'm going to announce that I will be live. In the morning, I will be live and I will tell you what the life is going to be about. If the Lord has blessed you in any way, if the Lord has touched your life in any way since we've been starting the broadcast and you want to testify to the glory of God, don't hesitate. Tonight, today, your day, your afternoon, your morning, the Lord is going to meet you at the point of your need. I need to go and rest. I have been up since 6 a.m. I need a sleep. I need to rest. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord uplift you. May the Lord favor you. May the Lord settle you. May the Lord be with you. May the Lord make his face to shine for you. Those who fight against you will no longer see you to fight with. People who fought against you, people who did evil against you would come to you and they will begin to say, you know what? I am the one who did this. I am the one who did that. The Lord will make your enemies to speak all the evil that they have done in your life. The Lord will make your enemies to come and confess. The Lord will bring the evil one to come to you and bow down and say, you know what? This is what I did against you. This is what I said against you. Every evil verdict that the enemies declared and proclaimed for you is hereby converted to good news. You will testify. Listen to me. If you have never testified since you were born, I am telling you that you will testify. If you have never given a testimony in your whole life since you were born, the Lord has not blessed me. The Lord has not done anything for you. The Lord will do something for you to bless his name. So many of you, the reason the Lord is not doing so many things for you is because even when the Lord does it, you refuse to testify. Oh my goodness. Houston, Texas is hot. Maybe I should relocate and come here, right? God bless us. God bless us. God bless us. It's like I'm in Africa. God bless us. God bless us. God bless us. Is there anybody else for a prayer request? We are going to log off. Just go ahead and say, thank you, Jesus. Go ahead and say, thank you, Jesus. Go ahead and say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for answering my prayer. Thank you, Jesus, for your blessings tonight. Go ahead and give God the glory. Go ahead and give God the thanks. Go ahead and give God the thanks. Go ahead and give God the thanks. God bless you, sweethearts. The joy of the Lord has always been my strength. I don't have another choice. Where do I go? Who do I go to? Saving God is all I'm going to live for. Working for God. Declaring the Lord. Preaching the word. Taking the gospel far and near. Going round the globe. I'm preaching the word of God is my desire. God bless you. 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 To the people that are in US, they are very lucky. As my leg has stepped in this land, the things that you were not able to recover, as my leg has stepped in this land, everything begins to work in your favor. everything begins to flourish for you. I call forth your lost glory. I call back your last glory. I call forth everything that was missing in your life. That as my leg has stepped in the land of US, restoration begins to take place in your life. Restoration begins to take place in your life. Restoration begins to take place in your life. The moment I landed, the Holy Spirit says, this one are so lucky. These ones are so lucky. I had my own boyfriend for how many years? I never visited in the US, but I came to the US to do the work of the Lord. Ah, if you are not blessed, if you are not blessed, then the Lord is not on his throne. I call forth restoration in this land to locate you. I call forth the restoration of this land. I give to you the key of prosperity in this land to reign in your life. I give to you the prosperity of this land to happen in your family. I claim every good thing in the land of Houston, Texas to work for you, work in your favor, work in your everything that you begin to do, whatever it is that you are finding difficulties. I shadow the blessings of God on your brain right now. I shadow the blessings of God upon you that everything about you is experiencing a turnaround altogether. I release the blessings of God on you. I release the blessings of God upon you. I release the blessings of God in your relationship, in your marriage, in the lives of your children, in that pregnancy. I release the blessings of God upon your future, your tomorrow. I release the blessings of God in your generation. In your generation to come, I release the blessings of God upon your generation. I release the blessings of God upon your generation. I release the blessings of God upon your generation. You would never lack. You would never lament. You would never suffer. You would never go down. You would never be sick. You would never complain again. The Lord is restoring you in every area of your life. The Lord says that he uses our strange feet. He uses a strange visit to bring back things, to mold things, to reconcile things. May this be your portion. The sun, the shoe, the cloth that I brought from the land of Canada, every good thing that is happening in the land of Canada, I bring it here to you and I drop it. That the goodies of Canada will never dry from this land of US. That the goodies of this land will begin to work on this broadcast wherever you are. I put you in the success, in the prosperity, in the wealth, in the good things that are happening in this land of Canada and US. That they will begin to take portion in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. My feet are blessed. My feet. How many of you knows the song? My hands are blessed. My legs are blessed. In my head is blessed. Everything is blessed. Ha! Ramashantarabaskaya. Everything. I release that blessing. I release that blessing. And I stand on the promises of God, which is the Bible. I stand on the promises of God. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Speak to your children, Lord. I release that blessing in the name of God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. I release that blessing. In this land, in the mighty name of Jesus. I wanted to read the word of God that the Lord has for us, but my light is too bright. I cannot see anything. I put my hand on the scripture and I removed the blessings in the word of God, and I said, every blessings in the scripture, every blessing that was written in the word of God, I put my hand tonight, because I want to bless you from my heart. I said, tonight I am coming to bless. I put my hand on this scripture. This is the word of God. This is the word of God, the Holy Bible. What version is this? This is King James.
Let me see if I will have a different version. This is King James.
Look, King James.
This is also King James. I wish it was a different Bible.
That is King James. And this is the International Children's Bible. Okay, and I'm dropping the two Bibles. These are all the Word of God, right? The enemy thinks that he has. The enemy thinks he knows something. When I get into the Spirit and work for you, eh? When I get into the Spirit and work for you, even your ancestors who stay in their grave and begin to ask themselves question, who is that lady? Rama Shantararaboskaya. I am untouchable. I am too great for the devil. I stand on this word of God, the word of God in different version, in different manner, in different areas, International, King James, whatever scripture it is. I stand today and I release every blessing that is in the word of God. And I said, receive it in the mighty name of Jesus. I put my hand again on the word of God and I take all the blessings that is in the word of God and I give it to you. I say, receive it in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm giving you the blessings from the word of God now. I take all the blessings from Genesis to Revelation, from New Testament to Old Testament. I take the promises that are in the Bible, the blessings that the Lord commanded for his children. I put my hand and I pack it. I say, receive your blessings. 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 In your family, receive. In your marriage, receive. In the life of your children, in your job, in your healing, in your endeavors, in your debt, in your mortgages, in every area of your life that you're experiencing and wanting the blessings of God. Receive the blessings of God. May the blessings of God never dry from your home. May the blessings of God never depart from your life. May the blessings of the Lord locate you day in, day out. In your going out, may the blessings of God receive you. In your coming in, may the blessings of God await you. In the mighty name of Jesus, I bless you in the name of God the Father. I bless you in the name of God the Son. I bless you in the name of God the Holy Spirit. The nation, your world, your generation will call you blessed. The Lord has blessed you tonight. Nobody can curse you. I cover your blessings with the blood of Jesus. I cover your blessings with the fire of the Holy Ghost. I cover your blessings with the arrow of God. I cover your blessings with the machete of God. Whoever comes to steal the blessings of God from you, the machete of God will machete them. Whoever comes to steal your blessings from you, the arrow of God will strike them. Whoever comes to take your blessings from you, the arrow of God will strike them. The Holy Ghost fire of God will burn them down. I cover your environment with the blood of Jesus. I cover the arena with the blood of Jesus. I cover the environment with the blood of Jesus. I cover the environment with the blood of Jesus. I cover the environment with the blood of Jesus. Give me a second. Somebody give me a second. I'll be right back. Somebody give me a second. I'll be right back. Somebody give me a second. I'll be right back. That's fine. I wanted to do something. I wanted to lay my hands. That's okay. That's okay. The Holy Spirit stopped me. May the blessings of the Lord remain with you forever. It is well with you. It is well with you. Until I come your way again, remain ever blessed. God loves you as much as I do. I love you so very much. I love you so very much. I love you guys so very much with the love of God. And my greatest wish, above all wish for you, is heaven at last. I wish you heaven at last. I wish myself heaven at last. I wish every viewer heaven at last. And I pray that the Lord will meet us all when it comes to rapture his saints. Bless you. Bless you. Bless you. I bless your week. May this be your best week ever. May this be a week of testimony for you. May this be a week of breakthrough, open doors, divine blessings, unmerited mercies, endeavors. May the Lord open a new chapter of your life in this week. May the Lord prepare you for exploits this week. You will never lack for the rest of your life in this new week that we are. The prosperity, the blessings, the mercies, the divine of everything will remain with you forever and ever in Jesus' mighty name. See you tomorrow. Have a blessed night. Have a blessed day. Have a blessed morning wherever you are. May the good Lord richly bless you. If you did not share this broadcast and you want me to love you, go ahead and share the broadcast. I am going to check. When I finish, I have seen all the names. I've seen Angela. I've seen Emmanuel. Let me check. I've seen all the names. I'll go and check. Janet, all of you. Monta, Angela, Savior, all of you. I'm going to check. Aileen, if you have not shared, if you have not shared, you're going to have a problem with me. I'm going to check. When I am done, I'll go and check all the broadcasts. To everybody that left a message for me, to every soul that left a message for me to pray for them, I cover you with the blessings of God. I cover you with the blessings of God that the Lord will locate you. In every problem that you wanted prayer for, I pray for you that the Lord will visit you. Even when I am not there in the physical to pray with you, to agree with you, always know that my God sees you. Pick any of the video, watch, the blessings are there. I release blessings on this video for people that will view today, tomorrow, in future, in the mighty name of Jesus. I release blessings on this video that the power of God will remain for anybody that will view later. In Jesus' mighty name, it is well with you. I love you guys so much. Until I see you again tomorrow. Bye-bye. God bless you. Bye.